list, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I ball. Man, like every day. For all the time, nobody helped me. Said I ball on you. Man, like every day. For all the time you dated, man, I ball. Man, like every day. Until the day I pass away, I say I ball on you. Man, like every day. Man, like
every day. Tonight. From Las Vegas, Nevada. Super Bowl 58. Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs taking on Tom Brady and the Atlanta Falcons.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion Kansas City Chiefs taking on the champions from the NFC, the Atlanta Falcons. Brandon Gordon along with Charles Davis, and what a season it's been for our AFC champions. I mean, this was a fight just to get to the Super Bowl. You got to figure that they are very battle-tested and ready.
I'd agree with you 100% about that. You don't get there without having those types of attributes, and that's what you look for in a Super Bowl team. Character, confidence, these guys don't lack for either one of those. Now they're here. Now they're ready to win.
Meanwhile, our NFC champions, they have gone through a lot to get where they are. Everybody knows their story this season. What's the key for them as they start this Super Bowl?
Let's go full cliche on this one because it works. Remember what got you here. Been a winning formula all season long. This is a team that when we saw them in the preseason, we said they look like a group that has what it takes to be a Super Bowl winning team. And we've been proven right by what we've seen throughout the season.
So it all comes down to this. We are ready, and Super Bowl 58 off and running from New Orleans. On the return, here's the dangerous Cordero Patterson. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. And here's a look at their leader, standing 6'4".
And he comes in off of a tremendous game in the NFC Championship round 2 weeks ago. This has been a team all season long that's really taken their identity from their quarterback, and he's been very vocal in days leading up to this game that he believes that this is their time, and he's going to do all he can to will them to a Super Bowl win.
Brady now on first down. And his throw is incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
On second and 10, Brady, this complete to Jones. And he's brought down at the 34, call it a gain of 4. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Throwing is Brady on third down.
They'll get this out to Kamara.
And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out.
A lot of times the key is just get him the ball and let him do his thing. And they got it out to him on the left side, and he did exactly that. Excellent run after the catch.
So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 44-yard line. Brady to throw again. And here is a leaping catch. He pulled it in. And they'll wind up getting this with all the way down inside the 20. So four plays, Charles, all passes here on the opening drive and already in the red zone.
And even if you're planning for them to throw the football a lot, on the opening drive, if they go 4-for-4 on you, you're off balance on defense. I've been there before. And part of you keeps thinking, they've got to run it at some point, right? They've got them really mixed up at this point. If I were them, I'd keep pressing the advantage. They're throwing it really well.
And just a couple yards there down to the 17.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
This will be caught just inside the 10. Touchdown, Falcons! With a first touchdown of this Super Bowl and a long one at that. And the Falcons are on the board first here in this Super Bowl. Well, these guys have won 3 straight ball games and another good start to this one out to the 6-0 lead.
And I've talked with so many different coaches, as have you along the way, and they always talk about winning streaks and the mood of a team and how much easier it is to actually prepare during that time. Guys are sharp, guys are focused, everyone's feeling good, and we're seeing it early in this one.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The KC offense set to go, led as always by the gunslinger, a former MVP in this league. It's Patrick Mahomes.
And he's been sensational all season long, but he saved his best work for the playoffs, leading his guys to the AFC Championship a couple of weeks ago. And now he knows what lies ahead. He's going to need to play a near perfect 4 quarters of football to get his guys to the finish line.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up 1st and 10 at their own 22. First carry for the ex-Utah State Aggie, Darwin Thompson. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down. Now here's Mahomes. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, 3rd down. So the failure to connect on 2nd down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Throwing now is Mahomes. Hit as he throws there, incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on 3rd down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on 3rd down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
Here's the Chiefs punter now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. On the return, it's Kamara.
So holding there on the return, and that'll back him up to start the next drive.
Yeah, that's a pretty easy call right there, partner. I think when the officials look in their manual and see the expression, jersey getting pulled, that's a flag coming out every time.
On first and 10, here's Brady. Open man is Kyle Pitts, his tight end. They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Brady now on first down. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Similar to a shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now we had a guy who made the catch. They try to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
To throw once more on second and 10. Brady throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. So now third and 10. They had the big play to start the drive, but two incompletions since. Brady gonna throw. Oh, he's got his tight end Pitts complete. And he is going to have a Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Had the offense humming on the first drive. Not much has changed here on drive number two.
No, and I think a lot of times confidence just really kicks in for a team. They may have been confident going into the game, but once you prove it on a drive, it's hard to get out of that mindset, isn't it? And look, let's face it, we can always lock in on the skill position, guys. Those big fellas up front, they're really making this offense go early in the game.
On first down, Brady. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Again, they'll throw with Brady. On the check down, he finds Kamara. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Brady. That's going to be caught by Pitts. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line.
They brought in a heavy set on third down, and that usually means running play, but we have seen him throw out of that formation. And sure enough, they snuck the tight end out on that one, wound up hitting him for a first down.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. Here's Brady to throw. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Tom Brady with two first quarter touchdown passes. And the Falcons will add to their first quarter lead here in this Super Bowl.
It's not much as perfect in football, but that's about as close to it as you're going to get. Score, force a punt, score again.
And both drives were impressive. The opening drive was, that last one was. Now on the other side, though, what's your psyche? You're really behind the eight ball.
You got to make sure you just hold in there. Survive the early storm, relax a little bit, and try and get back to your game plan. It's way too early for panic.
Tucker with the extra point, and that'll make the score 14-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. They go play action. Now Mahomes. And he drops this off to Thompson, complete. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four. Nothing to score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Five men in the secondary now for the Falcons on third down. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
When you struggle on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Here's Mahomes to throw. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
He's going to find his tight end, Gray, complete. That catch good for five. It's third down. On play action, it's Mahomes. Oh, this is intercepted, intended for Hill. Picked off by A.J. Terrell. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown. What a moment for him, a pick six in the Super Bowl. You think about some of the big pick sixes over the history of this huge game. I remember, because I was watching with a lot of Colts fans, Tracy Porter picking Peyton Manning to get the Saints' first title.
Yeah, that one pretty much sealed the deal for New Orleans as well. But I got to go back a ways because, you know, unfortunately, I'm considerably older. Herb Adderley, the Green Bay Packers, got it all started. The first pick six, Super Bowl II against the Oakland Raiders, and some of the better ones that were out there. You might remember Dwight Smith of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers had 2-1 game when they won their Super Bowl championship against Rich Gannon in Oakland. You mentioned Tracy Porter already. How about James Harrison of the Steelers? You remember that one? 100 yards right before the half ended? That was a big-time play. But for me, the absolute classic, Willie Brown in slow motion against the Vikings for the Raiders. The grand old man, Willie Brown, 75 yards.
You recall him on. What a play here. Another pick six in the Super Bowl. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does best and knowing that taking care of the ball is paramount. Here's his opportunity.
It comes back to those defensive backs for the former DB, right?
I don't know where that comes from. It just kind of emerges out of me for some reason.
It's deep in there, right? Yeah. Here's a handoff out of the gun. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
The Chiefs on third down, just one for three thus far. This will be third and six. Working from the gun, Mahomes. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
A short game that doesn't get them the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. Here's the Chiefs punter now, as he'll come on to kick this one away. Now after the punt on that play, we've got a man down on the field. We'll take a break and get a report from Vegas after this. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Throwing on first down is Brady. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack.
But that's what they have to do more of defensively. Not just getting sacks, we have to keep getting in his face. Not let him get his feet set and deliver. He's been carving them up previously.
Yeah, already has a couple of touchdown passes. About time they put a few grass stains on that jersey. To at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Now Brady. He hits his target, Lockett. And they will get him down, but not before he gets very good yardage there, as that will lead us right into the two-minute warning. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. To throw is Brady. Man open here is Jones. And they move this all the way down to the nine. So a little extra on top of the big play there.
It's tough for guys rushing the passer, but you have to know when the ball is gone. And if you listen, officials will tell you ball's gone. He didn't pull up.
Throwing now is Brady. toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Second down and goal. Brady escaping the pressure right. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Tom Brady taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Falcons are starting to open things up here in this Super Bowl.
I'd have to say we're all a little bit surprised there, because at his age, with his speed, or should I say lack thereof, the only rushing touchdowns I would expect are on quarterback sneaks. But here, he found all of his guys covered, and he said, why not? And by the way, if that doesn't fire up your team to see the veteran like that risking his body for the touchdown, I don't know what will.
Now Tucker to add the PAT. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now. A drive there of just 4 plays, and it results in a 4-yard touchdown run. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Patrick Mahomes on his way out for their next drive. In second quarter, they're down big already. He's struggling as well. They've got to find something here. He's got to find something on this drive.
And sometimes you take on all that extra pressure on yourself, and maybe you have to disperse it a little bit. Lean on some other people, lean on your teammates, find someone who can take the pressure off and get the ball in their hands for a while.
Or this, if he doesn't, this is getting out of hand, or it could get worse. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack, down he goes. Call it a loss of 5, a big sack to bring up third down. Now Charles dealing with a third and long. They'll have to try to go back to the air again, and this time avoid the sack.
Certainly hard to try to establish momentum when all you're doing is going backwards, not protecting the passer, and he gets dumped on his backside.
Gonna need better protection here. Third and long following the sack for Mahomes and company. He'll decide to keep this once more. And he's gonna be out up around the 45-yard line. I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react. Even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL, they're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They fake the give. Now Mahomes. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill. Complete. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 55 yards. And the Chiefs are on the board here in the final minute of the first half.
I'm not sure that they have illusions right now of, okay, we're going to score 8 times in a row and we're going to be terrific. But to get one, that was huge for them. That has to feel much better right now.
And you do have, we're still in the first half. You do have the entire second half. There's something about that goose egg that just looked bad on that board, but now they've broken it.
Yeah, broken through. Can they maintain the pace? We'll see as we go along.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and that'll cut the lead back down to 21. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. To return it, Alvin Kamara. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. Tom Brady leads the offense out for their next possession. And he's been good. Two first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence, does a great deal for your team, gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going
to
say, now he wants the first-half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
On play action, it's Brady. Caught on the right side by Jones. Past the 20.
Oh, touchdown.
Tom Brady, his third touchdown pass of this first half. And the Falcons continue to look good here in the first half of this Super Bowl.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
So what can Brady do here is he'll lead his guys up to go for two. Brady's going to look to throw, and it's intercepted at the goal line. Read it well, and it's picked. And the Falcons are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line.
Well, as most teams do in their two-point attempt, they pass the ball. Instead, it gets intercepted. And remember, if you pick it off, you got a chance to take it all the way back and get 2 points yourself, right?
Yeah, not the case there, but that's why you got to be really careful with those throws, especially to the outside. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Set to take over, Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs. A lot of the problems have been on the other side of the ball. Is that frustrating for a quarterback who's been playing well?
It is, but there's no way that the best ones let their teammates know that. They actually take it upon themselves and say, okay, I have to do even more, or I need to play better. Maybe even say I put my defense in a bad spot. That's what true leadership shows you.
Yeah, well, he doesn't need to change much personally. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeout. Mahomes, that's going to be caught. It's Jacoby Myers. And he takes this thing way down into Atlanta territory. Now another timeout called for by the offense, as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes throwing the out route and complete. It's Myers. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. Looking to throw again on second down. Mahomes steps away to his left. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down. Mahomes now to throw. That's caught left side by the tight end, Gray. And he will be very close to a first down. See the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. so it's halftime here on sports' grandest stage in the Super Bowl. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a season this has been. Hard to believe it ends tonight. As we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment. Thus far, this Super Bowl has looked less like a contest and more like a coronation. And to call the second half, let's get it right back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thanks very much. Fine work as always as we welcome you back for quarter number three. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. And the Chiefs ready to go on offense to begin quarter number three. And right now, their chances of hoisting that Lombardi trophy, not looking too great, but perhaps that long halftime, maybe it did them a world of good.
But if there's ever a chance to regroup, it's in this game, right? Because you do have that long halftime, a chance to really assess things and maybe make some changes and true adjustments. They've played great all year long. That's the worst first half of the season for them. They're hoping to put it behind them and come out punching here in the second half.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. They go play fake. Mahomes on the move to his left.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. That's caught left side by Hardman. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Well, maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I'm wondering if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game, because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good all game long, but a nice throw there for a good gain and a first down.
From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Now Mahomes, sliding out of the pocket. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with second and a yard. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. Now on first down, rolling to his left, and he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. Ahead of the chains now, second and 2. Now they'll throw with Mahomes. Gets this into the hands of Gray, the tight end.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Gray. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Throwing again on second down. Mahomes, and in for the Chiefs touchdown. An 11-yard touchdown. And the Chiefs are able to cut into this lead as they score on the opening drive of the second half.
As a general rule, quarterbacks don't want to lock in on a receiver before the ball is snapped. But in this case, based on the matchup he thought he was going to get, it was favorable for his tight end. He locked in on him early and found him for a touchdown.
Butker now to add the extra point. And the lead is down to 20. A good drive that time as they go nine plays in all. And it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result, had he opted for the touchback. The spotlight now focuses on the quarterback, and that's Tom Brady. And it's safe to say he has been getting his money's worth in this one.
I would agree with that totally. Being able to go back and launch it and air it out, and let's face it, it's not just him stepping back and flinging it, though. You've got to have someone who can go get it. And that's important for any offense, someone who can stretch the field, or as they like to say, take the top off of a zone defense, open things up, because then you can come back and throw underneath and gain some pretty good chunks of yardage as well.
He's ripped the top off of whatever defense they've been playing. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
Third quarter, Super Bowl 58. Here's a second and 10 now. Here's Brady. Eluding the pressure right. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Nick Bolton gets him for a loss of a yard, and it will bring up third down. Well, there was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Now to throw. That's into the hands of Pitts, the tight end. Touchdown, Falcons! The fourth touchdown pass of the game for Tom Brady. And the Falcons are starting to pour it on the game's biggest stage. They are running away with this Super Bowl.
You have fun with this one, partner.
I am. He's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving them up.
Four touchdown passes, carving them up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. So what can Brady do here is he'll lead his guys up to go for two. To throw for it. Looking there for Pitts, but intercepted. Picked off by the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. And the Falcons are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone and makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Out comes Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs offense. And the numbers for the last drive, and he was perfect, which maybe isn't surprising because he has not missed a pass in this game yet.
And it lets you know just how precise things have to be for a quarterback to be perfect, because that means the line's blocking really well, no one's dropping any of the passes thrown to them, and the quarterback is accurate. It's almost like a pitcher throwing a no-hitter or a perfect game, isn't it? He's the principal guy, but he needs a lot of help.
Time to find out if he can keep that perfect game going here, partner. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Mahomes going to throw. Throw over the middle, caught by the tight end Gray. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Super Bowl. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 41. Looking to throw is Mahomes. A quick slant to Hill, and they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant, a lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. To throw again on second down. Mahomes, he finds his man complete. That's Gray.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to 1.
And again, it's Mahomes. And his throw's gonna be incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. It's an 8-yard pickup, and that's going to bring up a third down. Throwing now is Mahomes. And it's caught. Touchdown, Tyreek Hill, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl, and the Chiefs are able to draw a bit closer.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, 1 by land, 2 by sea. He didn't mention air, because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's 2 touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that into the broadcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
Butker on for the PAT. And that'll make this a 19-point game. So that drives 7 plays in length. And it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And a good job here by the Falcons. Their hands team able to recover it. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here.
I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
On first and 10, here's Brady. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving, keep them moving.
I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football.
The throw on second down by Brady is incomplete.
The Falcons on third down. A perfect 4-for-4 thus far. This is third and 10.
Now Brady.
And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. Brady to throw for it on fourth down.
And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Chiefs defense comes up with a stop. So they were really trying to put the nail in the coffin there already with this lead here in the fourth, but they didn't get it.
Guaranteed, it's not going to be a fun handshake in the postgame, right? You just know that there's going to be some bad blood there. And I know if we go to the postgame press conferences, the winning coach, you know what he's going to say, why he did it? We need the points, okay? Because you never know at the end of the year if points are going to come into the tiebreaker if we're trying to get into the playoffs. That's always the standard justification.
Oh, this is intercepted, intended for Hill. Darius Slay with a pick, and he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line. With the points that we've seen scored, neither defense has been at their best, but these guys, they've been a little bit better, Charles, and a nice interception there.
Yeah, you're right about that, Brandon. Let's face it. It's not always how you start, it's how you finish, right? So maybe you have a rough game all the way along, but if you make a big play like that at the right time, it can make everything turn out just okay.
So after the INT, it's Brady. He'll let this go deep for Ruggs. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Legarius Sneed. And the Chiefs are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line.
Well, this D, particularly the secondary, has been picked apart at points here tonight. They finally, though, get to the quarterback, get a pick.
And we know this about him. He loves night games, loves the spotlight, loves being the center of attention. I will bet you that he ran off the field almost chuckling to himself. They finally got one. They finally got me.
You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
And that one's going to be off target and incomplete.
Okay, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? The leg's still there? This has been a tough game.
Now here's Mahomes. He is going to find Hill here. And he will have a Chiefs first down. They needed four. He doubled that. He wound up getting eight.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. It's a slant to Hill. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays.
Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. A loss of four that time on the sack, and it brings up second. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. Throwing on second and 14. Mahomes got some real estate inside the 30. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 22-yard line. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Mahomes firing complete. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Looking to throw again on second down. Mahomes, and he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Mahomes to throw once more. Flushed out right. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Patrick Mahomes, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Chiefs have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like, yeah, you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
Extra point by Butker is on target. And they're able to cut this deficit down to 12. So 2 scores down. Time definitely not an ally. But here comes the onside kick. And this is going to be covered up by the Falcons. And that should just about seal it. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Atlanta regains possession of the football. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all 3 timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. Brady gonna throw here. Man open, that's Henry Ruggs. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Big connection on that one. 34 yards.
Just more of the same there, partner. Guys have just been running free in the secondary this entire game. No pass rush. A lot of passes completed. Been an easy day for them.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Into the red zone, it's Brady. Now he's got it, and he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. Brady going to throw. And oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. Not much there, only a yard.
One-handed, love the effort. Not much production on that play, though, huh?
Not a whole lot of yardage. You get that grab, you probably want a first down.
And he'll be the one in the film session if he's saying, hey, run that one back, coach. Yeah. Run that one back.
One more time.
Let's see that
again.
Two more
time.
And they won't.
Eight more times.
They won't. Didn't get much out of it.
On second and goal, Brady. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. Brady now on third and goal. This to Pitts, and he's got him. Touchdown, Atlanta. Kyle Pitts, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Falcons are feeling good as they extend their lead in this Super Bowl. No surprise there. Third and goal down here. That's where they're going to look for their tight end.
Yeah, you want that big guy running his routes because it doesn't matter who they cover him with. If it's another big guy, he might use his bulk against him. If it's a shorter defender, might go over the top. Either way, you tend to find a little bit of a mismatch in that area.
They'll try and run it up the middle. And he gets halfway there, down to the 1-yard line.
Well, they couldn't be happy that they were having to stop a 2-point conversion because that means they gave up a touchdown. But a little solace there. You saw some good gang tackling, stacking him up before he can get to the end zone.
We talk about offensive units putting in more 2-point period sessions in practice. Defensively, do you do the same?
Absolutely. You have to because you never know how aggressive these offenses are going to be in games nowadays.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. And Kansas City's offense now set and ready to go. And their Super Bowl hopes are dwindling here in the fourth. That AFC crown from 2 weeks ago starting to seem like a distant memory. And this one just has not gone as they had hoped. Throwing on first down is Mahomes. And that's going to be incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down. Throwing is Mahomes on third. And that ball incomplete, nearly intercepted. Took a chance with that one. It'll lead to a fourth down. If they're going to have a shot in this Super Bowl, they're going to need this one on fourth down. Now Mahomes got to have this one. They complete it to Hill. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. And a timeout coming in. This will be their final one with 10 seconds remaining. Now it's Mahomes again. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining.
You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Back to the air on second down. It's Mahomes. He's going to float this over the middle deep. And a high throw there as this is knocked away down to the ground and incomplete. Fair to say the secondary play, whichever side you're on, hasn't really been a glowing exhibition so far. But a nice job there to prevent a long completion.
I agree with you. But at some point, someone had to make a play and try and stop this exhibition of almost speed racing that we've been watching, huh?
Yeah, it has been quarterback and receiver done. And Mahomes misfires again, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And the Falcons come up with a late turnover. But it'll probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over. it's over. The Lombardi Trophy belongs to the Falcons. Yes, the Atlanta Falcons are the Super Bowl champions. And to the Super Bowl champions, they etch their name forever in NFL immortality.
That's pretty phenomenal right there. It actually gave me chills just to hear you say that, because immortality forever and ever. When you look in the record books, you'll see this team, you'll see their picture, that your name will be a part of it. That's got to be an incredible feeling, because it's been a long journey to get there, and now they get a chance to enjoy it.
Just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.